Hello, friends. My name is Andreman Chavez, and welcome to Q&A on Queer Space Magazine, where I talk about what it's like to be queer and Asian, because it ain't easy. Today, I'll be talking about the origins of Filipino queer history through the story of Babaylans and Asogs. Growing up, I had a hard time accepting my queerness because it didn't fit with my Asian identity as a Filipino. I never had role models or influences of Filipino queer excellence or power, which influenced my perceptions on my identities. I felt I wasn't valid or visible, and that I wasn't normal. I recently interviewed some queer Asian activists, and one mentioned to me how we as Filipino gay men originated from the Babaylans. I didn't know who the Babaylans were, so I decided to talk to my parents and put in the time for research. What I found amazed me. The Babaylans were a group of indigenous Filipino women who were a warrior priestess class. They were fighters, political leaders, and healers. Although the Babaylans were exclusively women, they did allow a handful of men to participate in their practices and sacred ceremonies. These men were called Asogs. Asogs were men who considered themselves more like women than men in their manner of living. Asogs were femme Asian men who were demeaned by society for not showing interest in traditional male roles. They didn't want to do the typical norm. They didn't want to participate in marriage with women. It turns out, the Asog way seems pretty familiar to a certain femme Asian. I wondered why the visibility of Asogs wasn't prevalent in my education of Filipino history. My parents, who both grew up in the Philippines, didn't even know who they were. I had learned that in the Philippine Revolution, where the population fought Spanish colonizers, revolts against the Spanish were reportedly led by only men of power. However, research has shown that Asogs were also at the forefront in some of these revolts. They were dressed in fine skirts and robes, and I can't help but yes at the idea of a group of femme Asian men like me in robes and skirts at the forefront of a war fighting off colonizers. They were a group of femme men facing doubt and judgment for their femininity who fought off conformity to gender norms. They proved everyone wrong by harnessing their femme identities and joining a group of powerful women who together helped the indigenous tribes of the Philippines thrive by successfully winning the Philippine Revolution. One of the reasons why I never addressed my intersectionality growing up is because I could never link my two identities as a queer person and as an Asian person together. This is mostly due to the visibility of queer Filipinos in the past and in the present. Young queer Filipino Andre would have benefited a lot from knowing that he had these powerful femme ancestors from indigenous tribes in the islands of the Philippines. On those days where I doubted my excellence, I could have been reminded of the excellence and power that my Asog ancestors upheld. I wanted to share the story of the Asogs and the Babaylans because their story and what they stand for resonates a lot with my own work as an activist. Young, queer, Asian people should know that they aren't weird or different. They have ancestors who were just like them. The Asogs were strong, brave, unafraid, and proud, all traits I aim for as a young gay Filipino American with big hopes and dreams. They gave gender norms the finger and lived their truth. They fought colonizers, won, and proved everyone who demeaned them for their femininity wrong. I also couldn't help but resonate with the Asogs because one of my biggest hobbies is fighting white people and their colonial ways. Stories and visibility have so much power, and I hope their stories inspire young queer Asian people to believe in their excellence, in their identities, and the power that not only they uphold, but also the power their ancestors that came before them had. I'm Andreman Chavez, and this has been Q&A for Queer Space Magazine. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.